Repasuhin lang po natin yung mga guidelines po ng DTI para pa, alam mo yung yung isa sa advocacy ko talaga consumer rights. Kasi simula nung namatay na si Vic Dimaggi, baba yun, yung isa sa mga talagang nasusulong ng consumer rights. Protection. Parang wala na talagang vocal, ano, na talagang isulong yung mga karapatan po ng mga consumer. Lalong-lalo po sa panahon po ng e-commerce, yung mga online selling po natin, Secretary Chris. So itong ano, yung mga may reklamo po sa online seller. Yes. At marami po yan, nabibili na peke, ganun po.
Yes.
Bigyan lang natin sila ng giya. Yes. Kung paano kung if they feel na sila ay kumbaga sabihin na natin nabudol.
Yes.
No?
Nabudol.
May gustong isole, ayaw, di ba?
Yes.
Para hindi dumating yung produkto mo.
Hindi. Yes. Sa nag-order ka ng computer, ng laptop, tapos pagdating sa ano mo, di ba, parang
notebook
lang, di ba?
Notebook.
Yes.
Bigyan na lang natin sila ng tips. Guidance.
Yes. Okay, now October is Consumer Month. Mm-hmm. So this one, we really create awareness to let the public know that the government or even the DTI is really making sure that the consumer rights are protected. Mm-hmm. In fact, we have what we call the Bureau of Product Standards, meaning we cannot sell products that don't pass the standards of the DTI. Mm. So meron talaga kaming standards that are being met, and we really have a group that really enforces and that really monitors and really checks all these people that are not following the standards that are being set by the DTI. Madami din nagre-report, no? But you can actually report also to consumercare@dti.gov.ph or report to SEC at dti.gov.ph in case you encounter these kinds of situations, no?
Na-try ko na yan, it works. Meron akong rineklamo. Dinulog ko talagang tutulungan
po kayo. Yes. Because ang main goal is really to protect the consumers. Even the products that are being brought to us, let's say food, no? Food products that make complaints. First, hindi sila pwede magbenta na hindi FDA approved. So, and for our mamamayan, they also need to be vigilant na pag nakita nila yung item na binebenta, let's say pagkain, hindi siya FDA approved, it's better for them not to buy this kasi hindi natin alam kung what's inside the product.
So, yes. Sec Chris, yung mga ano ba, does it still hold true? The customer is always right. Pagdating sa DTI, yan ba talaga ang inyong ang mindset na regardless kung ano yung reklamo, ang customer ay laging tama?
I mean, we always also check on the consumer, no? Kung ano talaga ang reklamo niya and all that. But we also see the other side of the manufacturer. So, ano kami, more on give and take, or we look at both sides talaga of the situation.
Mm-mm. Kasi more and more, like ako, I don't go, hardly ever go to the mall. So, talaga ako, I shop online.
Online,
kailangan talaga, yung DTI should be on top of it kasi maraming peke ka na bibili.
Yes.
And the online platform does not, I wonder, kunwari, sinumbong ko na nga na peke yung tinitinda nitong merchant. Why doesn't Shopee or Lazada blacklist that merchant? Yeah. Makikita mo, naka-up pa rin siya.
They actually, we're working closely with them because there's been a lot of complaints already. So, Shopee and Lazada and the other online platform are really also taking this into consideration, and we're really policing this already. Actually, medyo strong kami ngayon on the enforcement side.
So kung ako ay seller, gusto ko magbenta sa mga online platforms, kailangan ko rin ba humingi ng DTI permit?
Yes,
kasi
diba
yung mga brick and mortar, nakapaskil talaga doon may city permit, diba? May DTI permit.
Yeah.
Pero yung mga online sellers, paano namin alam na sila ay DTI accredited?
Actually, that side, no, that's already on the side of like Shopee and Lazada. But for us, they have to make sure they're compliant with the things that are needed. Let's say the business name registration or the SEC. And if they're selling food, they have to be FDA approved. So in our side, that's what we police. But on the side of the, let's say, on the online business company, we really have to deal with them on these issues. In fact, medyo strict na kami dito sa mga online companies. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Kasi since the pandemic, ang trend talaga is
yes.
But what about, kasi madali pag local yung seller.
Yes.
But most ang daming goods are from mostly mainland China.
Yes.
And from abroad.
So yes. So we're really policing this. We're really enforcing this. Actually, we know this problem, and it's like an ongoing problem. So it's an ongoing enforcement also.
Correct. That's it. Evolving.
Yeah. Evolving. Diba? Parang they don't stop. Diba? Oh, parang ngayon ito, then the next thing ito na naman. So dapat continuous ang enforcement talaga.
And I think yung pakikipagtulungan ng DTI, because I think a lot of them can get away with not issuing receipts.
Mm. Yes, that's
so,
also,
yung
yeah.
So yung kita nila, hindi talaga nare-report, di ba?
Yes, yeah.
Sayang kabanang bayan yun, di ba?
Correct,
I don't
yes.
think they're being taxed correctly.
Yes, so BIR is also very strict now on the collection of taxes and also on policing these online sellers uh-oh. Also mm-hmm. and online companies mm-hmm. also. Together, Sunnet 25, Sunnet 25.